In an ideal situation, ranchers and range managers like to see cattle actively grazing on a broad spectrum of the range. Especially on hot summer days, some cattle like to hang out in the shade and creek bottoms to stay cool. Often, it requires herding cattle uphill to remove them from streams and riparian areas. But what if a cow is genetically inclined to climb hills? In a new research study, University of Idaho beef specialist Jim Sprinkle and his partners have identified a genetic marker for hill-climbing cattle. These animals, shown in the green dots on the slide, hiked more, ate less, but still had optimal weight gain. The implications of the study are significant for overall range health, experts say.
All things considered, when we can get cattle that really will venture out and utilize better, the range stays in better condition, especially those riparian areas stay in a lot better condition. And I really think for the overall long-term health of the range, and which includes those riparian areas, then it's really gonna help provide an opportunity to do a better job of managing.
Cattle use of riparian areas is a big deal on public lands. For ranchers, meeting required riparian standards is important for maintaining their grazing permits. It's an important issue for anglers, hunters, and the general public as well. Many species of birds and wildlife benefit from healthy riparian areas. Healthy riparian areas also provide quality fish habitat, reduced water temperatures, and good water quality. From the standpoint of Wyatt Prescott, range manager at the University of Idaho Rinker Rock Creek Ranch, the study's findings are significant.
We're really trying to figure out how we can use livestock as a tool for conservation and to enhance wildlife habitat.
Now, I think this information is very significant, and it's like most things, the more that we learn, then the better we're able to manage.
Sprinkle created one-of-a-kind collars for cattle equipped with an accelerometer and GPS to track their movements. The accelerometer measures the cow's activity 25 times per second. The GPS tracks movements every 2 to 7 minutes.
It's pretty powerful, the accelerometers. They use them on rockets. It measures velocity up and down, side to side, backward and forward. The GPS will tell you where they're at. The accelerometer will tell you what they're doing while they're there.
Sprinkle and research assistants ground-proof the data by recording cattle activity on tablets while riding horseback.
Lots of data. Millions of lines of data, millions. Each cow, each day, we get 2.16 million lines of data. We average it down to 180,000 lines of data for each day. We got 35 cows.
For the research project, Sprinkle and his graduate student, Landon Sullivan, compared the movements of 18 efficient cows versus 18 inefficient cows over several grazing seasons at Rinker Rock Creek Ranch. To get started, they ran mother cows through a squeeze chute to place the collars on the animals. Sprinkle and his crew had all of the collars laid out and organized. They painted numbers on the mother cows for easier identification. Jim Sprinkle wanted to see how cattle with different eating habits in a feedlot setting would perform on the range. In the study, efficient and inefficient cattle were observed in a true rangeland setting at the ranch.
They've done this work since about the 80s, but they haven't really looked at these animals out on rangeland to any great extent. And so when I came here in 2015, I saw a real opportunity to evaluate these efficient versus inefficient animals on rangeland and see if there was any differences.
Using a car analogy, the inefficient cows in a feedlot setting were heavy eaters and required a lot of fuel, like a 1970s muscle car. The efficient cattle ate less in a feedlot, but still had the same amount of weight gain, more like a turbocharged sports car. And the efficient cows turned out to be the champion hill climbers. The inefficient cattle were more lazy, hanging out in the creek bottom, especially when temperatures got hot in August.
My original thinking was that we probably want inefficient animals out here, because we want animals with a lot of drive and appetite that's going to get out and forage. And that's the beauty of science. It just, when we did the experiments, it just turned that right upside down. And so we have determined those efficient animals, when you have steep terrain and you've got hot temperatures, they seem to handle a little better than the inefficient animals.
Ranchers may want to select for hill climbing cattle if they have a range operation.
But if you have the opportunity to select an animal that is going to eat a little less and use more rugged country, especially when it's hot, it might be something to consider.
Prescott sees a lot of value in the research findings for Idaho ranchers because the study was completed in a true rangeland setting at Rinker Rock Creek Ranch.
We're really trying to make sure that the research conducted is super applicable to those ranchers and to those ranchers that are trying to use livestock as a conservation tool and create a better environment for not only their years to come, but for wildlife and all the public to enjoy.
Sergio Arispe, a professor of range science for Oregon State University, has been assisting in the research.
Right, what I'm excited about is really, we're currently at the forefront of understanding and learning more about cattle behavior. Once again, the cattle behavior is important for landscape management and the sagebrush steppe. What's also unique about this project is that it's answering questions that cattle producers have. And not only cattle producers, but public land managers as well. And so it's the combination of rangeland-based operations, academia, public land managers, and also industry all coming together to promote functionally healthy ecosystems. And so I would say this project is at the forefront and what we're all looking at and learning from so that it can move beyond Idaho and really impact the world.
For more information about the study, contact Jim Sprinkle at sprinkle@uidaho.edu.